Hi folks, welcome back to this wonderful channel. Welcome to OWUUBII channel. Before I proceed, don't forget to subscribe, hit on the notification button, and also like my videos as well, because I have more to share. So in this particular video I'm about to do, what I seek to do in this video is to let you understand or let you know that you can actually create multiple Wi-Fi SSIDs in Mikrotik. You can achieve this through the using of virtual Wi-Fi interface. That's what you can use to achieve creating of multiple Wi-Fi in Mikrotik. So kindly sit back, relax, and see me or watch me configure this multiple Wi-Fi SSIDs for clients to connect to. You understand? And this is often done for certain purposes. If you want to segregate your Wi-Fi for people to connect to, maybe you have Wi-Fi for your managers only to connect to, Wi-Fi for only your staff, and for all your guests as well. So we will go through these configurations and configure it together. So kindly relax and watch me do this. Thank you. In this configuration, we are going to tackle how to create multiple Wi-Fi SSIDs in Mikrotik router. So without wasting time, let me go straight to the wireless interface. So this is my wireless interface, and as you can see, I have created one virtual WLAN already here. Okay, so I'm going to create, as I said, I was going to create an SSID for managers, for the staff, and for guests as well. So let's start with creating for managers. This is our virtual WLAN. And so you go to wireless, and then the mode is access point bridge mode. Then you can select a customized channel you want, or it should be on auto. Okay, so let's say I want it to be on auto. You select the SSID. So this is where you actually type in the name for the SSID. So this is manager. So manager's Wi-Fi, right? Okay, so before we even come to this part of it, okay, okay, no problem, we can still go ahead and do this. And so manager's Wi-Fi, the master interface. Mind you, this is a virtual Wi-Fi I'm creating, so it needs a master, a default master to work with, which is the WLAN, which is the default on this Mikrotik router. So I choose WLAN as the master interface, and then I go ahead and choose the security, the type of security I want. In these times, I've not created the security profile for this particular virtual Wi-Fi I'm creating. So later I'll go to the security profiles and create the security and assign it to this particular interface. So let me leave it at default. Later I'll do that, and then we will all see. Internet working profile, I leave it at default. So basically you leave all this at default. So you leave it this way, and then you create your let me even give it a name, okay, so that I don't get confused. So managers Wi-Fi, okay, so this is managers Wi-Fi. So if you look at the wireless type, it is virtual, okay. Let me go ahead and create the next one. So the next one, we set it for the staff. stuff, Wi-Fi. Okay, so also in AP bridge mode, the channel, you leave it at default or you choose auto. So the SSID stuff, Wi-Fi, okay. The master interface, WLAN, of course. Security, I'll deal with that as well. Okay, so basically I'm done with this. And then I click apply and then okay. Then you go on and create the next one again, which I said is for the guests. So AP bridge mode as the mode. The channel, the secondary channel, you can choose any or auto. The SSID, I said guests. Guest Wi-Fi. The master interface WLAN 1. That because that's the default. Okay. I'll do the security profile as well. You apply and okay. The next thing I want to tackle now is to come to the security profiles and create security for each SSID. Okay. So I'm creating one for managers Wi-Fi. The mode is dynamic. And here I'm choosing any of these Wi-Fi authentication types. So this is what I want to use. Okay. So let me hide the password here. So manager 123. Manager 123. Okay, I've created that for the manager's Wi-Fi. Then the next one is stuff Wi-Fi. I want to use the same authentication type. Then I type in the password stuff 123. Then I do for the last one, which is the guest Wi-Fi. Okay, then I type in guest 123 as a password. Okay, so now I'm done creating the security profiles for the SSIDs I created earlier. So I need to come back to the Wi-Fi interfaces and edit the security profiles I've created. Okay, so first let me deal with the guest. I said I've created a security profile for guest, so I'm choosing guest here. I'm done. The same thing goes with the manager's Wi-Fi. The same thing goes with the staff Wi-Fi as well. Okay, so I'm done creating the virtual Wi-Fi interfaces for various groups to connect to. The next thing to do is to assign IP addresses to these interfaces and also allow them to do DHCP server. So you need to come to IP, pool, right, this is not necessary at this moment. It can be also be done, but let me go straight to the addresses and create address for the interface. So the first one is managers Wi-Fi. So this is my, let me say, I want to assign this IP. Okay, so what managers Wi-Fi? Okay, so this is it. I created an IP address for the manager's Wi-Fi interface. I need to do the same thing for the other ones as well. Okay, so I'm creating this for the staff Wi-Fi. And let me create the last one. the last one for the guests, Wi-Fi. Okay. All right. So I'm done creating IP addresses for the virtual Wi-Fi I created. I'm not done. The next thing is to create your DHCP server. And then you are done. Okay, so this is a DHCP server. Let me create for the last one. I mean for the first one. So manages Wi-Fi. Okay. Okay, so I'm done creating for the manager's Wi-Fi. Let me create the next one for staff Wi-Fi. Okay, as you can see, these are IP addresses I've created already, so they are just being used to create the DHCP server. Okay, right, so I'm done. Right, I'm done with the whole setup. Okay, so currently I'm going to try and connect to one of these interfaces and see if it's going to give me a DHCP and probably allow me to browse the internet. So let me take out my cable. Okay, all right. Okay, so let me try and connect to one of them. Great. So as you can see, these are the Wi-Fi, virtual Wi-Fi's I created in Mikrotik. 1, 2, 1, 2. Stuff. Where are you? Okay. 1, 2, and 3. Okay. So I'm going to connect to one of them and see if I'm going to have access to the internet. I said manager 1, 2, 3, right? Okay. Let me see. Bingo, it's working. You see? So I can browse it. I can reach, you know. Bam, it works. Okay, it works perfectly. Let me try the other ones and see. Let me try the guest. Okay. So guests, 1, 2, 3. Okay, guests 1, 2, 3. Okay. So basically this also works as well. Okay. So if we come to our DHCP server, we'll be able to see. So guest is active. And so guest has released this IP for my machine. Okay, these are the other one I connected to as well. Okay. Alright. Yes, so we've come to the end of yet another video. I hope you really got the clue and the knowledge of how to actually create multiple Wi-Fi in Mikrotik. Mikrotik is a very powerful router and it contains a lot of features that makes your work easier and more fascinating. Okay, so just grab your Mikrotik router. It's not so much expensive as well. Just grab it and then work around it, you find so much solutions with Mikrotik, and I bet you it will make your work easier. Okay. All right, so thank you very much for watching this video.